When climbing a peak near home or abroad, I make a route map before I go. Let's talk about why this is a good practice, even if you think you know the route. Hi there, I'm Jason. For all my alpine climbs or summit hikes, regardless of season, I make a topographic route map. I find the process of making the map has very real benefits beyond just having a map when I'm done. I start by using the CalTopo free software and either draw in or import in a GPX file that will make my primary route. And while this GPX track will just end up on my GPS device, I find it extremely beneficial to take the time to visualize the route on the topographic map. I can notice things like important direction changes in the route, areas of relative steepness signified by tightly grouped topographic lines, areas of potential exposure being next to tightly grouped lines. I can see landmarks like drainages and lakes and the general shape of ridges. I can see the number of likely false summits. I'm also better prepared to make good route finding decisions when visibility is low. I was once on a 13,000 foot peak across the basin from a very popular 14,000 foot peak in Colorado. And on that climb with my boys, I met two separate parties who were wondering how to get to the summit of the 14er. Well, they were across the basin. They turned the wrong way from the parking lot, following the wrong trail. They didn't recognize the summit shape of their objective, so couldn't recognize their error before too much of the day was gone. It's the process of planning the route that makes me aware of how to read the terrain of the climb once I'm in the field. But next, I start to think about bail routes. And while I do this all the time, it is especially important when I have kids. If we need to go down, reversing the route will always be my first choice because I have knowledge of all the terrain I've already covered. But I need to be prepared for eventualities like surprise storms that may demand that I lose altitude in a more direct way. So bail routes usually mean finding potential gullies or faces that make fairly direct descents to lower elevations. If I'm on an alpine climb and have technical equipment and ropes that I can use to rig a rappel, the slope angle of the terrain is less significant. But if I'm on a scramble or a hike and lack that equipment, I need to know the slope angles so that I am less likely to end up on terrain that I can't navigate. Luckily, with CalTopo, I can simply activate the slope angle shading layer and find the approximate slopes. It's important to draw in potential routes carefully. You want to be very sure that you aren't getting into prolonged amounts of even steep-ish terrain, as that type of terrain can hide small sections of something that may be impassable. A classic example of this is the too early gully on Capitol Peak in Colorado, which ends up leaving climbers cliffed out, unable to move up or down, and which was the site of 3 deaths in 6 days in 2017. I'll turn on slope shading and then draw in potential routes to lose elevation quickly, labeling them as such for the benefit of my GPS device. Now, what I can't tell from the topo map is whether the terrain I am choosing is talus or boulders or ice slopes or whatever, but now I know the features I'm looking for as I start my bail route. So on my approach, I can examine my bail route for features that I can only see in person. Thanks for coming to the end of this video. Please hit that like button, ring that bell and subscribe, and check out our website at shortguysbetaworks.com to find gear lists, all of our videos, and additional thoughts and information. Do you have any must-do activities as you prepare for your hikes and climbs? Let us know in the comments. See you next week, and keep on getting more out of that big outside.